Good morning students. Today we have to study the chemistry 8th lesson, atomic structure. Atomic structure. Okay. Already we are studying in 8th standard. We have to study two important atomic model of an atom. So the two important atomic model of an atom, Dalton atomic model and J.J. Thomson model. Yes. Okay. Now we are going to study Rutherford atomic model. Rutherford atomic model. Okay. So the Rutherford discovered nucleus by his famous gold foil experiment. Gold foil experiment. What is nucleus? Nucleus is the center part of atom, and it is the combination of proton and neutron. Here he selected a gold foil and alpha particle. Okay. Here the alpha particle is passed through a thin part of gold foil. Do you understand? Thin part of gold foil. Why we are using gold? Gold is a malleable metal. What is the meaning of malleable? The metal is converted in the thin sheet form. Okay. Now you see the apparatus. Now you take alpha particle generator. Okay. Alpha particle generator. Then he passed the beam of alpha particle. Beam of alpha particle over the thin sheet of gold foil. Now what do you see? Some of the alpha particle can be deflected. Some of the alpha particles can be deflected. But most of the alpha particle goes in a straight line. Most of the alpha particle goes in a straight line. So, he have some observation. The first one is, most of the alpha particle pass through the straight line. Okay. Then second one, some alpha particle slightly deflected from the straight path. Then third one, very few alpha particle completely bounced back. Okay. Do you understand clearly? Now you have to study the observation of Rutherford atomic model. Okay. The first point, the atoms contains large empty space. What's the meaning? The atoms contains large empty space because the most of the alpha particle passed in the straight line. Most of the alpha particle passed in the straight line. Okay. Next one. There is the positively charged mass at the center of the atom. Positively charged mass at the center of the atom. It is known as nucleus. It is known as nucleus. Okay. Next, we are going to study the third point. The size of the nucleus at the atom is very small. Very small compared to the size of an atom. Compared to the size of an atom. This is the third point. Next, fourth point. The electrons revolves around the nucleus in the close circular path. Okay. That is called orbit. That is called orbit. Next one. The atoms is electrically neutral. Why it is neutral? Is having the same number of proton and electrons. Okay. Once again, I explain. You are listen carefully. The first point, the atom contains large empty space because the most of the alpha particle passed in the straight line. Okay. Then second one, there is a positively charged mass at the center of atom. It is called the nucleus. So Some of the alpha particles slightly deviated. It means the center part of the atom high positive density. High positive density. Understand? Some of the alpha particles slightly deviated. So, it means the center part of the atom high positive density. Okay. Next, third point. The size of the nucleus of an atom is very small compared to the size of an atom. So, listen, the size of the nucleus is too small to the size of an atom. Okay. Next point, the electrons revolves around the nucleus in close circular path. It is called orbit. Okay. So the Rutherford model is otherwise known as solar system model. Solar system model. Okay. Here high positive charge mass is present in the center. So it is called nucleus. So the electrons revolves around the nucleus. Okay. It is moving in the closed circular path, which is known as orbit. Do you understand? Rutherford model is otherwise known as solar system model. Okay. So, here the high positive charge mass is present in the center. So, it is called nucleus. The electrons revolves around the nucleus. It is moving in closed circular path. It is called orbit. Okay. Next one. Here, the atom is electrically neutral. Why it is neutral? Here, the number of protons and electrons in an atom are equal. Okay. Now you are going to study the limitation in Rutherford model. Okay. So, according to electromagnetic theory, a moving electron continuously accelerate. Okay. So, if the electron is continually accelerate, what happen? It lost the energy. It lost the energy continuously. So, if it is continuously moving, it lost the energy. Here, the path is reduced. Then, it is fall into the nucleus. Okay. So, the atom is unstable. But, atom is stable. Okay. Now you are going to study the Bohr's model of an atom. Okay. So Bohr's model, he explained the stability of the atom. Okay. The main postulates of the Bohr model is, first one, the electrons revolves around the nucleus in the stationary circular path. Stationary means fixed. Okay. So, it is moving in the fixed circular path. It is called orbits or shells or energy levels. Okay. Once again, listen carefully. In atoms, the electrons revolves around in the nucleus in a fixed circular path. It is called orbit or shell or energy level. Okay. Then second one, while revolving around the nucleus, the electrons are neither loss or gain. So, what's the meaning? There is no energy change in the fixed path. Okay. Next, third one, the electrons in a shell can move to a higher or lower energy shell by absorbing or releasing a fixed amount of energy. What's the meaning? Now, the electron is moving to lower energy to higher energy. Okay. So, the lower energy shell to higher energy shell, it must gain or absorbing some amount of energy. If the higher energy shell, the electrons are absorbing some energy. The, in the higher energy shell, the absorb, it absorbs the energy. Okay, suppose the electrons are moving in the lower energy shell, it lost the energy. It lost the energy. Okay, next one, the orbit or shells are represented the letter K, L, M, N. Okay, or the numbers N is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now you see the Bohr model. Here, center part. The center part is the nucleus. The center part is the nucleus. Okay. The first shell is K shell. Next, the second shell is L shell. Third one is M shell. The fourth one is N shell. K, L, M, N. These are called the primary shell. Okay. Here, you are considering the K shell. K shell. The orbit close to the nucleus is called K shell. Okay. So, it's having least amount of energy. It's having least amount of energy. So, it is called K electrons. Okay. Here, these orbits are associated with fixed amount of energy. Fixed amount of energy means here K shell, it's having N is equal to 1. And here L shell is having N is equal to 2. Then M shell N is equal to 3. And N shell N is equal to 4. Do you understand? You are going to study the limitation of Bohr model. Okay. Here in the Bohr model, it explains only in the hydrogen atom. Because hydrogen is the smallest atom. Yes. Hydrogen is the smallest atom. So, this model is only applicable to the hydrogen atom and hydrogen-like ions. Example, helium, lithium, beryllium. Helium, lithium, beryllium. Okay. It does not explain multi-electron nucleus. It does not explain multi-electron nucleus. Okay. Now, we are going to study the discovery of neutron. Discovery of neutron. Okay. So, James Chadwick is a scientist. He discovered the neutron in the year 1932. He discovered the neutron 1932. Okay. In 1935, he has awarded the Nobel Prize in Physics for his discovery. Okay. There are three particles in an atom. They are proton, neutron, electron. Already you know. Yes. Here, proton and neutron present in the nucleus. Proton and neutron present in the nucleus. But electron revolves around the nucleus in a closed circular path. Okay. So, here proton and neutron present in the nucleus and electrons revolves around the nucleus in the closed circular path. Now, we are going to study how the neutrons are discovered. James Chadwick fired the alpha radiation at the beryllium sheet. Alpha radiation at the beryllium sheet. Okay. So, this radiation produced uncharged penetrating radiation. So, this penetrating radiation consists of uncharged particle. Uncharged particle means it does not have any charged. Okay. So, it also having the same mass as proton. So, it consists of uncharged particles. These particles are called neutron. These particles are called neutron. Okay. So, beryllium plus alpha ray equal to carbon plus neutron. Carbon plus neutron. Okay. The neutron is represented by the symbol N01. N01. Neutron is the neutral particle in the atom. Okay, neutral means what? It has no electric charge. It has no electric charge. So, the neutron is represented by the symbol N01. So, the superscript 1 represents its mass and the subscript 0 represents its electric charge. It is electric charge and it represents the mass. Do you understand? Now, we are going to study the properties of neutron. Okay.
So here these particles are found to be deflected any magnetic or electric field. Magnetic or electric field. So what do you find out? Neutron is electrically neutral. Neutron is electrically neutral. So the mass of neutron is equal to 1.676 into 10 power minus 24 gram. Okay. So mass is equal to 1.676 into 10 power minus 24 gram. Now we are going to study the characteristics of fundamental particle. Already you know, matter is made up of an atom. Okay, matter is made up of an atom. An atom is a smallest unit. Atom is a smallest unit. So atom is composed of three subatomic particles. The three subatomic particles, they are proton, neutron, electron. Here the protons are positively charged particle. Okay, electrons are negatively charged particle. And neutrons are uncharged particle. Here listen, proton and neutron together to form nucleus of an atom. They are called nucleons. Once again, protons and neutrons together to form nucleus of an atom. They are called nucleons. Okay. Here listen, the electrons. The electrons are negatively charged particle. These electrons revolve around the nucleus. Okay. In different circular path. It is moving in the different circular path. This imaginary path is called orbit. This imaginary path is called orbit or shell. Okay. Now you see here, this is the structure of an atom. Okay. This is the structure of an atom. This is called a nucleus. Okay. So here proton and neutron together to form nucleus of an atom. Okay. Together to form nucleus and an atom. They are called nucleons. They are called nucleons. Here you are see here, these are the electrons. Okay. So the electrons are negatively charged particle. These electrons revolves around the nucleus. Okay. In different circular path. This imaginary path is called orbit. This imaginary path is called orbit or shell. Here you are listen. One chart is given. Particles, electron, proton, neutron. What is the symbol of electron? E minus 1, 0. Proton H 1, 1. Then neutron N 0, 1. Okay. What is the charge of the electron? Negative charge. So minus 1. Minus 1. Okay. Here proton plus 1. Plus 1. Then neutron. What is the charge? 0. Here 0. What is the mass of the electron? 1 divided by 1837. Next, proton mass is 1, neutron mass is 1. Then mass of electron in grams, here AMU, atomic mass unit. Okay, here grams mentioned clearly. Electron mass is 9.1 into 10 power minus 28. Then proton mass in grams, 1.6 into 10 power minus 24. Then neutron mass is 1.6 into 10 power minus 24. It is very important. So you are study very carefully. Okay. Students, now we are going to study the atomic number and mass number. Here the atomic number and mass number always whole number, because they are counting whole object like proton, neutron, electron. Number is equal to number of proton equal to number of electron. Number of proton equal to number of electron. For example, in sodium atom, you are taking the sodium atom. There are 11 electrons and 11 protons. 11 electrons and 11 protons. Thus, the atomic number of the sodium atom is 11, because the atomic number is 11. Okay. Next, we are going to study the mass number. So, mass number is equal to number of protons plus number of neutron. Number of proton plus number of neutron. So, the mass number, it is represented using the letter A. Here atomic number, it is represented the using the letter Z. Okay, here the mass number, you are listen, the for example in carbon atom, you are taking the carbon atom, there are 6 proton and 6 neutron. So what is the mass number? 6 plus 6 is equal to 12. Okay, you see carefully, X is a A, X is a A. Okay, what is X? X is the symbol of the element, symbol of the element. So the atomic symbol, okay. So the atomic symbol, it is used to represent the atom in chemical formula. Okay, here A, what is A? A is the mass number. So what is mass number? Number of proton and neutron in atom. Okay, what is Z? Z is the atomic number. Number of protons in atom. Number of protons in atom. It is represented with the letter Z. Okay. So atomic number is used to identify the element. Identify the element. One example is given. Nitrogen N714. 7 is the atomic number and 14 is the mass number. 7 is the atomic number and 14 is the mass number. Okay. Here number of neutron is equal to mass number minus atomic number. Here listen carefully. Mass number is equal to number of protons plus number of neutrons. Number of neutron is equal to mass number minus atomic number. Next, one sum is given in your book. Calculate the atomic number of an element whose mass number is 39. Mass number is 39 and number of neutron is 20. Number of neutron is 20. Also find the name of the element. What do you find out? Name of the element. Okay, so the solution, right? Mass number is equal to formula. Mass number is equal to atomic number plus number of neutrons. Number of neutron. So atomic number is equal to mass number minus number of neutron. Minus number of neutron. Okay. What's the mass number? 39. Now you write here. Next, number of neutron. Number of neutron is 20. So 39 minus 20 is equal to 19. So the atomic number is equal to 19. Okay. So element having the atomic number is 19 is potassium. So potassium represented K. Okay, students, today class is over. Thank you.